Hi my YouTube family, this is Melody from Home Garden and Fashion. Please welcome to Home Garden and Fashion. First of all, I would like to thank you so much for subscribing to my channel, and please do go to my Facebook fan page and give me a like there if you haven't been there already. In today's video, I would like to answer some questions and also some comments. I had many comments in my gardening videos for last 1 year. I've been having comments, so many people write me that I'm putting too many seeds into some of the pots and I'm not reading the instructions from the seed packages, and many my other even hate comments on my one of the gardening videos where I did little bit landscaping with the stones. So just to answer all those comments, I decided to make a video. So this I don't like reading all the writings on the seed packages, and I never have done those things all my life. From my childhood, from the time I was 8 years old, from the time I just learned just to pick up a seed, I started growing. And first in my grandma's house, then my mom's house, everywhere I grew big trees. And since we lived in India, so the climate over there is really good to grow basically anything, everything. So over there I grew all the fruit trees, the mangoes, the banana, the pineapple, you name it, I had it, all kinds of vegetable trees. And never did much for the gardening, the kind of things we see over here, all that new equipment you need to use, and the garden bed, and all sorts of different kinds of soil, and then the stones you put, limestone and this and that. I never have done those things, and I didn't believe on those rules. My gardening rule was only rule. I have seen a seed somewhere, I would just pick up the seed, save it, and put it in my garden. And as a fertilizer, I only put grass clippings, used eggshell crust. I use the eggs, save the shells, I wash them, I crush them, put it in my garden. And tea and coffee grind, the tea leaves, used one, I dry them and then put it in my garden. And all the fruits and vegetable peels, I used to dig a hole in the garden, put them all and cover the with the soil. And all the leaves from the other cleaning the garden, I would get all the leaves and I put them into hole and just cover the hole. And that's how I did gardening. And I grew so much from my childhood age till now. I never worry about reading a gardening book or doing by the book or following rules or using latest equipment or just to do gardening, spending so much money just to just buy things. I have seen in my friends' houses, in the name of gardening, they buy like thousands of dollars worth of stuff. But if you go to the house in the gardening time, actual time, you barely see even a single tomato in their plants. So I do not follow any rules. I do not read all the packages, the labels. I just get seeds and I put them in the ground. Even my seeds, I get them from fresh fruits, vegetables, tomatoes. From all the fresh source, I get seeds. I don't even go out to the store to buy seeds. It's always where if I got seeds free from somewhere, or I just have my own seeds from the fruits and vegetables I ate, I save the seeds. So today I'm going to share with you what on a daily basis I pick up from my garden. These are everyday vegetables I pick up. Over here it's hard to grow fruits in US because the weather is different, and I cannot grow a banana tree or mango tree or any other trees, fruit trees. But in India, I grew practically everything. Jackfruit, I had like 6 jackfruit trees. In India, my dad's house, I had about 40 papaya trees, mango trees. Every single fruit, I had tree, big trees. And it was just all the neighbors used to come and see that so beautiful big trees. And I didn't give them any care. I just gave them... just put the seed in the ground, and water came from the rain water, and sometimes we did water. It was very little, most of the time it was just depending on the rain water and whatever I found in home, I did the gardening with that. Didn't go out and buy anything. It was just gardening is something, you know, more like kids, like you love them, take care of them, and that's it. And they just grow like that. So this is what I get on a daily basis. Today I picked up lots of green ones. I'm going to turn them red in home. So I will put them in brown paper bags to turn them red. And then these are the beans. So I had one of the viewers who commented on my this string beans video that I should read labels from the beans packages. Well, I never do and I never will. I just get the seeds and I put it in the ground. First I put it in little cups and then I transfer them to the ground once they, and I have so many green bean plants, and in a daily basis I get like this. So far I got like 20 pounds of green beans. And these are the Chinese snow peas. Now they started coming out, so soon I'll be having like basket full every day. So today I have like this much and this much beans. So that's just for today's. So you saw the tomato, and these are the red tomatoes. I kept them a couple of days ago. I picked them up, so I put them in brown bags, and now they all become kind of orange red. So I'm going to do a next video about how I store this in my refrigerator. So I will show them how to cut them and store them. I'm saving all this since I have about 50 pounds of tomatoes. So I am storing them in my freezer so I can use them later. Now these are the eggplant I picked up little early. They could have been much bigger. But the reason I picked up because the squirrel and the rabbits, they some reason they love eggplants, and I tried with putting everything, the eggshells and everything in the ground, but the squirrels got really smarter this year, so they keep getting. So I picked up today's, even though they are really tiny little, but they are really tasty. And since I don't put any fertilizer, my vegetables really don't get huge. They're just tiny little. And this is the size you should get if you're just doing organic gardening. In organic gardening, you don't get to see huge fruits or vegetables. They're just normal size. The huge fruits and vegetables you see when you put a lot of chemicals, this fertilizer like Miracle Grow and things like that. And I don't use things like that. So my vegetables are just organic. So these are the bell peppers, which could have been a little bit more bigger, but I just picked them up. I'm going to make a mixed vegetable curry, so I'm going to use this eggplant and the beans and the Chinese peas and the bell pepper. Now these are kind of, I had a pickled cucumber, but out of these they started coming this circle round cucumber, so which is like funny looking, but they do really well for little on top of the sandwich. And sometimes I make juice out of it, and just to put it in the face, because I do work in the garden a lot, so I get sunburn. So I use tomato juice and cucumber juice. And these are my peppers. These are the green chili peppers. I picked them up yesterday, and these I picked them up today. These are jalapeno. So this is for just for today's, just for one day I get this much vegetable. And here are my greens. I like to eat greens every day, and these greens are the pumpkin greens. See the pumpkin leaves? These are nice dark green leaves. And I clean them and wash them. Now I'm going to chop them very finely. After I chop them, then I'm going to cook them. One day I will do a video on how to cook these leaves, and I'll show you. And they are really tasty. Basically what you do is you clean them and you chop them real fine, like very tiny little, like this little you chop them, this little. And make sure you pick up only the soft one, the soft leaf. and the soft branches, and they are really yummy when you cook them. So you cut them into very little tiny pieces, and then you chop up some garlic, about 4 or 5 cloves, and then put a little oil in your pan, nonstick pan, about 1 or 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Then you put some cumin seed, some garlic, and then you put this chopped up pumpkin leaves, and on top of that you put 1 tablespoon or maybe half a tablespoon, depending on how much you use, salt, and 1/4 teaspoon. Well, make it teaspoon, because tablespoon might get too much. So if you use less salt, let's say 1/2 teaspoon salt, 1/2 teaspoon turmeric, or maybe 1/4 teaspoon turmeric, and that's it. You cover it, and when it's done, then you can sprinkle some other spices, like I use some spices like curry powder, or there's a one masala called Karhai ghost masala. I use that one, about 1/2 teaspoon to 1 teaspoon on top once it's done, and that's it. You can eat it with boiled brown rice, and this tastes really good. So I'm going to do a video on that. So this video was just to show you what I get daily basis from my garden, and also I'll add some clips of the garden. Thank you so much. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share. And I will see you with another video soon. Thank you. Bye-bye. Hi, my YouTube family. This is Melody from Home Garden and Fashion. Please welcome to Home Garden and Fashion. Today, I'm going to give you a tour of my garden. So, this is my garden. As you see over there, the bush beans. Real bushy. And over here, the bitter melon. And over here, the tomatoes. More tomatoes. And all the way at the end of the Chinese peas. There's the eggplant. With some hanging eggplants. Thank you. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share. Bye-bye.